Thank you so much for spending time with us today on Central Valley Talk. I'm Mike Scott, joined now by Heidi Miracle, who's going to talk about young living. It's a line of essential oils.
Yes.
And we were talking during the break about some of the... You actually took a little sniff of one of those because you were feeling a little stressed out.
A little nervous. I've never done this before. But
well, did it work? Are you less stressed now?
Yes, I am. Totally. The Stress Away essential oil is really helps you calm down, calm those nerves down, and just... eliminate some of that extra stress that we deal with. So, yeah, very helpful.
Now, the skeptics are going to say, no, come on, how does smelling something, how can that make you instantly relax? Explain the process there.
Okay, so essential oils work on the emotional and mental aspect of our health, because when you inhale a fragrance, it goes to the part of our brain that corresponds with the emotions. And so inhaling a scent will affect your emotional area of your brain. And so oils are oxygenating, and they are very mood uplifting in their properties.
Stores know this, don't they? Stores sometimes will spray little scents without you realizing it that make you more likely to buy.
Yes, absolutely.
And Disneyland uses it all over the place.
Oh, really?
I didn't know that. When you walk down Main Street and walk by the bakery and think you're smelling the chocolate chip cookies baking, you're not. You're smelling a scent of chocolate chip cookies that they pump out into the street in front
of
the bakery. They're very smart.
Yes, very smart, Well, must understand how scents work on getting us to make a decision or initiate a response.
Yeah. Well, it's one of our main, right, sight, smell, taste.
Exactly.
I mean, those are all things we use every day. So.
Yes.
Yeah.
Totally.
So tell me about this Young Living line. What makes it different than other essential oils out there?
Sure, totally. Thank you. So Young Living essential oils are different from other essential oil companies because they have a unique seed-to-seal standard in which they monitor the process of extracting these oils from the plant material and every step of the way to ensure that you have the highest quality product that is going to bring you improved health. So if you have a tainted essential oil in any way, it's going to affect the efficacy of that product. So that's what sets Young Living apart.
How would they get tainted?
By adding a synthetic extender or...
How dare they?
Exactly.
So you're saying this is the pure stuff?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And it's guarded, like you said, from seed right through... the end product.
Exactly. You know, I've had the privilege of participating in that process. I've gone and helped harvest some of the plants for essential oils. And so I've been able to see firsthand that whole process and watch what it takes to go from the plant material to the bottle and what's in that bottle. So there's certain different essential oils that have my blood, sweat, and tears in there a little bit because I've participated in that process. So.
Wait, is that on the label, blood, sweat, and tears? If these are essential oils, why aren't we all using them?
That's a really good question.
Thank you.
I feel like there's just a lack of knowledge. Young oils have become a bigger blip on the radar in the last couple of years. But still just not a lot of knowledge about them. So what I do is I seek to educate people and teach them about the different properties and teach them about how they can integrate this into their everyday lifestyle so that they can receive the benefits.
Mm. In the old days, before prescription drugs, oils and natural remedies were just how things were treated.
Exactly.
It used to be the way things were.
Yeah, exactly. And actually, in the Bible, they refer to frankincense and myrrh. And those are, you can actually get them as essential oils and use that same, those same plants that were used in those biblical days.
Ooh,
so,
what does frankincense smell like?
It's kind of, it comes from the sap of the frankincense tree. And so it smells very earthy. Yeah.
Hmm. And what would you use that for? What would that help with?
Yeah, good question. Frankincense is very uplifting and supports a healthy brain. It's really good oil to use to connect with your spiritual side. So I often use it before I before devotions or before I pray or so like the Catholic Church use frankincense and in their ceremonies and yeah.
Well,
so
see the wise men knew what they were doing,
exactly,
right?
Exactly.
It was
yeah.
a nice gift for the for the little baby.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay, Heidi, you have an introduction class coming up later this week. You wanted to tell folks about?
Yes. So I have an introductory class to essential oils. It's going to be held at the Orchards Clubhouse. On Bullard Avenue, and it's going to be at 7 p.m., and I'm co-teaching this with several Young Living leaders in
Bullard
the area.
Bullard and what? Do you know?
I don't know, but the address is 5034 West Bullard Avenue.
Is that like an apartment complex? Or?
Yes. It's a clubhouse at
clubhouse.
The Orchards apartment.
The Orchards.
Yeah.
Okay. You can Google that and find out.
Yes.
And what time is that?
7 p.m.
7 p.m. Okay. Yes. Well, Heidi, thank you so much. Do you have your own website, or how can folks find out about Young Living?
You can go to youngliving.com. Also get a hold of me. My number is 541-480-2362. I just moved here from Oregon, and I can connect you with resources and information about future events.
Mm. Most people move from California to Oregon.
Yes.
The taxes are a lot lower in Oregon.
That is true.
You did it the other way around. All right.
Yep.
But we're glad you did.
All right.
All right. Heidi Miracle from Young Living Essential Oils here on Central Valley Talk.
Thank you.